GBR-11, Peterson May, Tom Thompson.
Again, that's you, 1-1.
There you go, you heard it right.
It is, well, I didn't look at it, but in years past, it has been half Stars and Stripes and half Union Jack.
Very good.
So, how'd that one?
The GBR-11, Peterson May, Tom Thompson, across the start-finish line. That is one of the brightest boats you will see out above the water.
Talking with his owner, Eric Hellstrom. Tony, you got the GBR right in front of you.
Yeah, it is a beautiful looking ride as well, as you just mentioned, as he came out of that nice and smooth.
Right,
really picked up a
lot of right looks good.
And
it
looks to me like he's really got his foot in it, Michael.
Yeah, you know, it looks like a solid ride, but it certainly doesn't look like the speed that we just saw with John Theoret earlier in the U96, and even Cal Pitts, I think, in the 27th. But we'll get him around the top end of the course and lane number one, the exit pin and turn number four. Nice job, steady job on the top end turn on the west end of the course here. And across the start finish line for the GBR 11, Peters and Tom.
First lap time for the 11, 143.426.
Yeah, he really kind of close on that one as he comes in, and he's really trying to get some time on this one. Oh, that's a little bit there, but I think he's going to make it right back up. Hey, guys, let me jump in here. While Tom Thompson runs hard down the backstretch here, we've been welcoming a lot of people back to the Tri-Cities, and one we want to give a big welcome to, Sean Theoret. Welcome back to the Tri-Cities, my friend.
Well, thank you. I'm really happy to be back and want to be racing for such a team.
And step right out on the race course, you average north of $1.60. That's got to be a good start.
I'm hoping it's going to be legal. You know, we've been flirting with the entry all day long, so it's hoping it's going to be legal. But I'm really happy with the team's been going with this, and God's good.
Well, one thing that I noticed, and I can't see the whole race course, whether it's legal or not, at that speed, you seem to be getting a great boat ride.
Oh, the ride is awesome. You know, the boat's really running fantastic. It corners very well.
You want another one, I assume, just as bad.
Absolutely, Doug.
Last 143 points.
One of the great guys in the world, and what kind of a speed have we got on the GBR 11, guys?
144.446.
Okay.
And up the back stretch is the GBR 11, Peterson May, with Tom Thompson. Again, at 144.446 on the first lap on the clock as he goes into turn number three, our four-quarter super speedway on the Columbia River. This is the Wallula Pool behind the McNary Dam.
With the jello shot.
Yeah.
Jello
shot. Chances trying to get over 145, but not much more.
And across the start finish line, the Griggs Ace Hardware start finish line, and 11.72. You know, it's a steady ride, but it's not a blistering thing.
1.5, 5.65.
Definitely, you can see the profile is a little bit different, actually a lot different, I would say, than Jean Theoret and the 96.
No, absolutely. Here we come across the finish line, started this first lap. Beautiful, beautiful looking.
Well,
it looks real
smooth. Just a little bit more.
Interesting comment about this boat. We're talking about Jean Theoret. With Mick and Plumbing back in the day, it was owned by Billy and Jane Schumacher.
Carried the nose just a little bit more on that straightaway, so be aware on this one.
Good news for him was it was the fine.
And Tony, quite a bit slower getting through turn number two.
Yeah, seemed to find a spot there where he slowed down, pulled back a little bit, and then has made it out of the exit side. He's just trying to find that right combination there. Get those gears put together there. Yeah, he definitely pulled off a bit when he was in the turn.
Nice turn up into the top end of the course on the west end here. And a turn number four.
Here, buddy.
NASCAR Super Speedway, lane number 3, the exit pin to turn number 4 down the front stretch. And now we start to see a little bit more air underneath the boat. And coming out of the water just a little bit more. And 149.461 miles per hour.
So he did take that speed coming down the back on the front side.
Hey, remember, you're in the wind again.
And down the back side to go.
So Tom Thompson in the GBR-11 Peters MA at 145 miles per hour, the best lap earlier, and now 149.461 miles per hour in that first lap. But you got to put two together to get the average, Dan, to get where you want to be.
Well, absolutely. And with these windy conditions and the choppy corners that are created, especially after the first boat ran, they're at, you know, they got the canard, they got foot pedals in there, they can help control some of that, fight some of that in the corners, but, you know, once they're downforce, once...
Okay, there's a 150.0, so we're going